Not everybody is capable of great athleticism. Not everybody is capable of high academic learning. But everybody that I know, especially every child, is capable of self-expression. And dance, I feel, is a beautiful way of bringing that forth into the world. I'm Colleen Perry, and I'm the director of Free to Be Me Dance. Free to Be Me Dance is an adaptive dance program where I teach ballet to individuals with Down syndrome.
Ballet is my thing now, so I'm now trying the basics of ballet now, so yeah.
It gives them balance, it gives them structure, but there's also something very free about dance. The favorite part of class for the children and for me is the free dance portion, where we play a song and each of them gets to be spotlighted and have their solo and do whatever comes to mind. That's really the power and the beauty of dance, when you don't tell a child how to dance. February of 2009, I came across an article about a woman who was named Mickey Casellas. Mickey was the physical therapist for the ballet dancers at the Boston Ballet. So she approached them to do a pilot program where some of their ballet dancers would teach the children with Down syndrome. And after I finished reading the article, a chill went up and down my entire body from my head to my toes. And this voice inside my head said, Colleen, this is what you're supposed to be doing with your life. And I couldn't ignore that voice.
Now to some very special children in a program that's giving them the ability to learn ballet and to believe anything is possible. CBS 2's Lisa Siegel shows us a class where lives are being changed one dance step at a time.
Wow. Bella McHugh loves her life.
You're 6 years old?
Yes.
Okay.
Today's my birthday.
No, it's not your birthday. Your birthday's January. Do you like to dance?
Yes, I love to dance.
See, this is a first for Bella, the chance to be a ballerina, all because of an extraordinary program.
Until I started Free to Be Me Dance, I still had never worked with anybody with Down syndrome, but there was something about it that I wasn't at all afraid. And I just knew that this population of people would be so open and so welcoming to what I had to offer, which was not just the discipline and perfectionism of ballet, but the joy and the beauty and the spirit that comes forth when you just allow yourself to dance. So the first two classes were joyful chaos, I like to call it. Then I got a little bit more of an idea about how to structure the class and how to keep the same consistency and ritual every single class. And that's when things really kicked in. The Boston Ballet program has given me my basis for everything that we do in Free to Be Me Dance.
Which one does the red one go on? Okay, on your right foot.
And what they found was that it was much easier to teach the children red foot, blue foot, rather than say right foot, left foot.
Left foot.
The other thing that they learned was complicated musical rhythms weren't so great for the children. Simple drum beats, simple rhythms are what the children really relate to. We find that there's about
like seven core families that have been with me. This will be our fifth year or so from the beginning, and then others have added on. From what I saw today, they integrated fantastic. Even little Natasha, she was friendly, she was perfectly behaved, she wanted to meet other people. I think it's gonna just be beautiful integrating the new dancers with the seasoned dancers.
It's so good to see you.
You must be Juan, the daddy, Colleen.
My name is Juan Marin, and my daughter is Natasha Marin. Natasha is 3 years old. She turned 3 in January.
When I was 6 months pregnant, we found out that Natasha was gonna have Down syndrome through an amniocentesis.
I didn't know what Down syndrome was, and I just had, like, I'm gonna say, the stereotypical view.
At a day old, Natasha had to have surgery to repair her intestines. She had what's called duodenal atresia. They had to connect her intestines to her stomach, and her intestines were also wrapped around her pancreas, so they had to cut out some of her intestines and fix that.
Yeah, Natasha's hearing loss, it's mild to moderate on both ears.
I was a little sad. I with hearing loss, I know that some people don't talk, so her not being able to talk is what really made me sad.
And I read in books that for kids with Down syndrome, usually people try to pick up on sign language to try to communicate with them, and we started by researching. It is scary because who doesn't want to hear the kids talk?
We're teaching Natasha to sign, "I want more cracker." Not just cracker, cookie, milk, juice, and to play.
Is it dance?
Dancing. Dance. So when we do come, we're telling Natasha we're gonna go to
dance
today. And Natasha loves to dance. She's always dancing at home to music. It doesn't really matter what kind of music there is. So putting her in ballet was a great opportunity for her.
Boston Ballet had started a program called Hand in Hand for the youngsters. And I thought if we started early enough, then more and more children with Down syndrome would come to love dance early in their lives. And it would be a nice flow into our level one dance class when they were old enough. And I knew that there would be something about involving the parents that would be really important for the development of the younger dancer. They get to discover what's comfortable for them and assert boundaries. Natasha began to dance and gallop when she was ready to, and that's really important that she knows there's a place where she can go at her own pace. The parents are a really supportive community. As a matter of fact, that's one of the things that they talk to me about, is that they get together. It's like their own little support group.
I had a very natural 9 months. There was no change, nothing, and I was young, and so there was no reason or no a sign that, you know, I was going to have a special child.
Then she was born. I didn't even know that she had Down syndrome.
The doctor was very abrupt.
The doctor came in and said, "We think she has Down syndrome."
She had just come out, and he said, there's something wrong with your child. And I said, my husband, what? And my husband knew. My husband goes, no, she's fine. And I said, count her fingers, count her toes. And it's just fine, she's fine.
And the doctor told me, there's something abnormal. Do you want to schedule, termination? And I was like, that's the option? I was like shocked this coming from someone in the medical profession.
After the initial shock wore off, it was like, okay, this is what we have to deal with. This is what we have to do. We just do it.
I didn't see anything wrong with her. I saw her as my baby. She was my baby. And I brought her home and she's my baby. She's always been my baby. She will forever be my, I always think of her as my gift. No matter what, they say the normal children, sometimes they're not so normal. Sometimes they're not as loving. Sometimes they can't express the love your child expresses in such a simple action. So I thank God every day.
You get this worst case scenario, and then you find out it's not that at all.
When you look at it, we're parents. We're parents to children, and we're no different from anybody else.
It's not the end of the world, and there's so much potential.
You would think, oh my God, life is over, and what am I going to do? But I think it depends on how much you put into developing the child. You spend the time and put the effort in, you'll get somebody like Bella who's lovable, laughs, and holds a conversation.
Hello, this is Bella, like you. I love to eat dinner with my sisters and my family. This is my daddy. He loves to kiss me and hug me and take me to ballet recitals.
So I think a lot of people have preconceived notions of what people with Down syndrome can do. What a lot of people have in their heads is that a lot of people with Down syndrome are maybe not as able to communicate. I think it kind of throws them off that, Bella actually can.
This is my room. That's me. I was in a red skirt. And my dad's in a white suit. That's my sister Lizzie Boyle and my mom.
As a parent, I know that the world is not going to be very kind to Bella in the long run, and she's going to miss out on a lot of things that a regular child would get to do. But for that 1 hour or 2 hours on Sunday, she's like the center of the universe and kind of a superstar.
You're all done. You ready to go?
Yes, Mom.
Bye.
Well, hello, Miss Bella McHugh. How are you, ma'am?
It really is a joyful thing for me to watch her because I know that that's what she really loves to do. And it gives her it really makes her focused and gives her kind of a purpose because she knows she has to go up there and she has to do it right. The pride that it gives her, it's the best thing.
My daughter is Melissa. She's 19 years old. Melissa has a twin brother, Michael, who, of course, is also 19 as of last Monday. Michael's a typically developing kid. He's a college freshman at UCLA. And we went through a long evaluation during the pregnancy and discovered that she had a heart defect. And as a result of that, we had an amniocentesis. That's when the Down syndrome was discovered. At that point, we didn't know anything about Down syndrome. We didn't know anything about heart issues. We didn't know what to expect. She had open heart surgery when she was 5 months old. And it really wasn't until after the heart surgery that it hit us. Melissa has multiple diagnoses. She has Down syndrome, but she also has autism. And she has apraxia of speech. And she has asthma. And so she has health issues. And she has this cardiac issue that very likely will require at least one more surgery in her life. And because of the combination of issues she's facing, when she turned 18, we went to court and requested a conservatorship be established. And so I talked to Michael about it one day, explained what it was. He had a couple of questions, and I explained to him that there will be family financial support and there will be government financial support. And he said, okay, Mom, I'll do it. And he went to court with me and signed the forms and, you know, thinks of himself as the person who's going to be in his parents' place when we go. And he made that commitment at the age of 17. Your brother. Yeah.
Always been like mommy to her, you know. It's in me to be like that, I guess. Anything that I can get her involved in outside of school, I do, and I take her to it. I guess I love her so much.
Well, she loves dancing a lot, and she'll go on YouTube and look up different dances and she'll dance to them. And I think that this opportunity gives her a chance to dance in front of people and to feel like she's part of something. And she gets to show off her dance moves.
Melissa loves to dance, and so the idea that there would be a program that could be perfect for her that close to home was so exciting to me. So we signed up immediately. We were there at the first parent orientation and at the first class, and she's been a part of it ever since. Dance and music and movement to music have been an amazing thing for Melissa because it doesn't require something that she doesn't know how to do, and she can be free in her movements. It's like the joy of her life, really. How do you feel when you dance? You do. Free to Be Me dance program, because it was founded specifically for children with Down syndrome, brought Melissa together with other children with Down syndrome. There is a bond there that they don't know where it comes from, but they share it. It feels like a second family.
I'm a little anxious because we haven't really had the whole company together to really go through the choreography step by step. So they've learned pieces, but they've not learned the entire thing together. So I don't know how that's gonna go. What's important is that they have a wonderful time.
Dancers of Free to Be Me Dance are dancers just like any other kid in any other dance class. And part of the joy of being in class is knowing that you're also going to be getting to do a recital at the end of the semester.
I have to say that this semester was a long time in coming for me. I had been planning for this performance, these costumes, the look, the choreography, for over a year.
These are the groupings of the ladies. Right, we have all ladies. There's a gentleman here.
There's two gentlemen. Yeah. They won't be here, though, till almost 1 o'clock.
Okay.
Yeah.
Loves the experience of all of this, but when it's brand new, she doesn't really know what to expect, and so she gets an anxiety. And the makeup in particular is something that she's never really been comfortable with. It's a sensory thing.
Daddy!
Okay.
Look up! Get off! Now! Oh. Sound me now!
Starting in kindergarten, Melissa was terrified of auditoriums and stages. Going into the performance, there was anxiety, and maybe stage fright is what they call it. But once she's up on the stage, she just lights up.
Love so you experience. Feel confident that she's going to get on the stage?
Oh, she'll get on the stage. Yes. Yeah.
1, 2, 3, go dance!
They really had a lot to learn. The level of choreography in this Thriller number is much more complicated than anything we've ever attempted in the past. I think they've been practicing extremely hard and even practicing at home. I'm really excited to see how the audience responds because we've not done this in front of anybody but the parents yet.
My name is Colleen Perry, and I'm the founder and director of Free to Be Me Dance. We are a nonprofit dance program teaching ballet and hip hop to individuals with Down syndrome. The performance you're about to see, is very special to me. The dancers have been working for over 12 weeks straight, both in the studio and at home, to get this routine down. And it's pretty complicated, it's pretty ambitious. I hope that you enjoy this next performance. Here they are.
Was the funny or not, she's the inspiration for the thriller dance. Mm-hmm. She started showing me the zombie dance that some kids at school had taught her, and I thought, oh my gosh, I think that's Michael Jackson's Thriller. And I thought, wouldn't that be a fun thing to teach the kids?
Perform, that was like the best gift she can give me. It was just, she had to see. This is how important it is for me to see her shine, because we don't get it, at least for her, she doesn't get many of these opportunities. And that's why I'm thankful for these classes.
To the person who put this all together.
I think the most important thing for someone to be able to work successfully with kids with disabilities is an interest and a heart for it. And I am so grateful.
There are a lot of moments in Free to Be Me Dance where I forget I'm not just teaching a ballet class, that there's a lot more levels of connection and belonging going on than I'm even aware of in any one given class. You know, sometimes I'm just really focused about being the teacher. You know? And it's in those moments when I stop being the teacher and I just have that moment to pause and observe that I see kind of all these little miracles that have been happening out of my awareness this whole time. And that's really, that's the most special part of the program to me.
Thank you so much.
Every time I walk into that studio on a Sunday and I get hugged by each and every one of those dancers, it just lets me know that everything's going to be okay and that I am loved, that I have this capacity to give love, and it just keeps going back and forth between me and the dancers that way.
I love you, Connie.
Every time I get asked what life is like now compared to what it was before, I describe it as, you know, we live on a different planet than the one we started on. It's like we entered a spaceship, and on that spaceship ride, some kind of technical problem developed, and we ended up on a different planet than the one we were intending to land on. But then we landed on this new planet and had to make a new life.